when we are calling again, and I know I'm doing this, and this is just because I don't know how much data Hearthstone takes up when you are actually playing the game. The main problem is if it doesn't play any minions, then I'm not going to be able to trade the doctor into it. Like, if the doctor has so much health, which is a problem actually. Oh shit. How about you get to keep all the cards so you don't summon them? I mean, I could still win. He would need to kill it off and then deal 6 damage immediately to me. Which he's probably not going to be able to do. If he had gore, how he could just kill it off immediately. But then, you know, like, yeah. I can deal 9... 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 damage I can deal right now. I have 18 damage on the board. And yeah, he's doing that because he needs to. Okay, so he can rush with that. He can rush with that. And he can trade one of the twos in. Does he go face or does he clear? Because he basically needs to clear now at this point. Okay, interesting. I actually wanna not attack with this. Which might... Ooh! No, 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 this is gonna be great. This is the best thing I could ever have. You know why this is great? Yes, it's a 9-8, but I make this into a 3-3. And then I will kill it off. And get my healing, finally. Comeback is real, boys! Comeback is real! And gals. Now I'm Batman, Adam West Batman. Old school Batman. Okay, wait, he played! What the fuck? But that's a hunter. Oh, weapon has been... Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. That could be bad, okay. But you know what I have to say to that? You know what I have to say to that? Hello! That's what I have to say to that. Buff boys. The thing is, unless he kills this, then he's not gonna be able to go face with the dragon. He might though, because he could use... I don't know what things he have. That's not gonna be able to go face, because that's not a mech. That's really, really bad though. So, yeah, I'm not gonna go through a 222, so he wins, I think. Unless... I might actually still be able to do this here. Maybe. Damn, that's a lot. Okay, so, well played. That's the well-played thing. Nice. Oh, man. Oh, man. Wait. Yeah, so many hellos. That's pretty hilarious. That was actually pretty, pretty fun, actually. That was a fun game. That was a very fun game, actually. Because that was pretty, pretty close to the end, and we got to see some pretty, pretty wacky plays there. I actually really, really like this deck, because it has a lot of potential and stuff that, and I definitely think that, yeah. I mean, that opening was just insane, and that he was able to come back for that, but he got very, very lucky with getting that dragon. If he wouldn't have gotten that dragon, then, you know... If he wouldn't have gotten the dragon, his Tar Lord wouldn't have been that strong. That's the magnetic justice. Where's the other thing? Even mechs love Greymane. So do we remove the chrysology right away? Because I mean, the only thing is really is 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. That's the only things that I have one attack. So there's only 4 things that have one attack. So that's why having 2 is bad. But I mean, there are certain other things that I could have that aren't makes that are good. Like, there might be certain makes that aren't worth using, like... Even though mechanizing them is good, or magnetizing them is good. Like this one, The thing is, if this had rush, it would be so much better. But this just adds one of those things. And Sparkle is so much better because it has rush and it's a 5-1 and it would do that damage. And this basically deals 6-7 worth of damage, basically, because it gives you 2-2s. And if you had a way to trigger the Death Rider as a Paladin, then that would have been insane. So we want to remove our Spark Engines, I'm pretty certain. Because, yes, sometimes it's really good, like early game, like it's really, really good to be able to rush into something with the Spark Engine, you know, that's really, really good. But, for example, our... Alright. I cannot use that, so mana... Even. Yes. I need to look at it this way because otherwise it's going to be confusing as hell. Because otherwise I would have used that. In an odd paladin, I can understand why people pick odd paladin over this, to be honest. I kind of wish you could regret your latest choice though. But then a lot of people would have used that if they wouldn't realize that the legendary they crafted is bad. But I won't say that this is bad because I love Gengraven as a character. And unlike the Varian, I'm just gonna disenchant him. I'm so pissed off that I had a gold Varian. It was a really, really sweet looking card, and then just, you know. So we removed the two Spark Engines because it's better. There are better cards than that that we can use. Probably if I would have had an equality, I could have won last game, probably. The thing is, Holy Light might actually be good if the game goes late enough, or to stop them with a Buke. Because I mean, I've gotten value out of my silver swords, definitely I've gotten values out of them. Leon Hands might be worth it though because of the Drak tree cards. So let's see what is powerful that we can use from this here. The thing is, we would want to replace it with something that's early game, I think. Because that was the whole purpose of that card, to be like early game. Well, that's the whole purpose of it. So do we have other good stuff? I mean, this would come to mind just because of the armor early on is really good. That's not too shabby. The spell damage is nice, but we don't really have any damaging spells. No, we do not. There are a lot of interesting things you could do. We could look down, like we could go two Defender of Augustus and have less early game and only have like 2, 3, 4 to have like 4 early game cards. And then of course we remove one of the crystal uses, as I said. We need to have like a gold one, right? Where is crystallage again? Yeah, we need to have a golden one. This is good though. Give me something divine shield because that can make it harder to kill off my stuff. So if I get this on a strong thing earlier on, then it's good. This seems really easy to pull off though. If I would have enough healing things, then maybe I should remove stuff and replace stuff with early healing cards. Do I have any early healing cards though, or are all the healing cards odd cost? Maybe the majority of healing cards are actually an odd cost. Holy Light is of course healing. Technically this is healing, but this won't count for the things that are affected by healing. No, I don't want sound bells. What else is healing? This is healing. Glassnet is of course very good. When you restore health, you regain Divine Shield. Oh man, imagine if they would have made this a mech. If the Glass Knight would have been some kind of mech instead. But I think that these should have another tag that should be a tag, and that's Construct. Because Constructs are like golems, but also like a Glass Knight would be a Construct, because Constructs are basically, they have like no soul, but they aren't like robots, because they are like, they are more like magical, they are like put back together with magic or whatever. So if you would go, for example, okay, let's say what would... So this would be a construct, which is basically what golems are. So which one of these would be a construct? Sankyptarium would technically be a construct, because he's a construct of the Titans. Basically, the Titans made him. So it's basically like, yes, he's a humanoid, but he's a construct. Humanoid isn't a tag in the game, so yes, this would be a construct. Something overall even constructs that I can see are not, basically, that are like minions. So let's go with the construct here. Instant Watcher. He is not a construct because he's still, he looks way too humanoid. And he doesn't look something that's like built by magic, because this isn't a golem, this is just a giant like kind of thing. I mean, maybe you count them as maybe that's the Egyptian version of a golem. That could definitely be the case, that they are in like Egyptian lore or like Persian lore. They are in Esfand lore. Isn't that the thing from? No, they aren't, because those look different. The things that are like in Arnkirage, right, they look different, they aren't like this. Or is this more from the Cataclysm? I wonder if that's the case. So what else would be a construct? I know there are more constructs than this, though, that you would count. Wraiths aren't constructs, by the way. Played a bit and all, that's a beast, so that wouldn't be a construct. And where did all the constructs go? I know there's a lot of constructs in Wild, at least now. Maybe the majority of the constructs are in Wild now. No, that's an elemental, of course. An undead elemental, basically. Love the Night Holder, by the way, the golden version of that. Because it's the Worgen. And if you buff it up, it becomes really scary. This thing I thought about being really good, because if you clear the enemy board and then you play it, then it's really, really good. Then, I mean, you basically want to always play it when the enemy has nothing on the board. That's actually not too shabby, really, if you think about it. Yeah, this becomes a 6-6, which is obviously worse than the lone champion. But the lone champion is a 3 mana, and that's kind of like a replacement for the lone champion. Oh, but in the even deck, you can have the Youthful Brewmaster to get an effect up twice, basically. So you could Youthful Brewmaster your Galvanizers. That actually feels like really, really strong, though. There might be no more constructs yet. This is disappointing. I thought there would be way more constructs. Still wish there would be an undead tag. But you could also count this as a construct. It's because it has bombs on it and stuff like that. Like, abominations are basically undead constructs. So this would have undead and the construct tag on it. Totally Stone Shaper, definitely a construct, just as he is the Sun Keep Tarium. And then you could argue that the Bone Drake would be like a Death Undead Dragon, but that's almost like a construct because it's animated by magic, so it's definitely fall into construct. So this would be Dragon, Undead, and Construct all in one, basically. Elementals are elementals, of course, although you can kind of call them constructs as well. But no, not really, because they serve the elements. But then there's a big difference between what is an elemental and what is a construct. I would say frozen crushers don't look like frost elementals. I don't think these serve the elemental lords, because that's the whole thing, that the elementals serve the elemental lords. They serve the world, basically. While something like Frozen Crusher feels more that would actually serve someone else, because a construct is something that serves a master, basically. A construct has like a master, or it's programmed to guard an area. And obviously this picture is from Angoro here, and that's Elise down there with her Knight of Ears there. That's Elise, Starseeker, and she can see that there are Murlocs inside the eyes here of the card. and stuff that. So this is basically, oh, this so-called elemental is guarding this area in Ongoro. Oh, it's guarding an area. Oh, what's that? There's no ice nearby, or there's no like water nearby or anything. So, I mean, I guess this is a little bit of water here. But still, it just feels like this is not an elemental. This feels like this is a construct that is designated to guard the Titan's secrets or something like that. So this is more of a, this is a construct, not an elemental. But I'm guessing they're using elemental things on things that would be construct. Although there are some constructs in the game that are actually called mix for some reason. So I mean, like, that's the whole thing also, that certain things that are mix now would be constructs instead. So if I just go in on, like, basically showing every card, basically just stand across, boom. Okay, so let's look up constructs here. So other stuff that would be constructs. I need to keep a look at now. Sometimes it's a risk that you're going too fast and then you miss what's a construct. I wouldn't say that that's a construct because it's obviously an undead horse, but it depends on if it's like a spirit, like, because a spirit, like, is it like, because, you know, so you could say that a spirit could be a construct as well. If it's like magical undead, if it's undead because of being like, if something has been cursed to become undead rather than becoming undead by actually dying, then you could call it a construct, because then someone casts a spell on it to make the horse serve them in death, and then it would be a construct. But it would be a spirit, like an undead thing, if it's a horse that died and then it died in a specific area and then it keeps roaming around the area and being like, nyeh bugger. It would say nyeh bugger all the time. But yeah, so more constructs. I know that there are other constructs. These are an obvious reference to that movie with the gremlin things, but these kind of look like the things that were in Munch Odyssey, like the Abe's Odyssey, like the Munch Odyssey one, the one on Xbox, which I 100% by the way, and that one had just like hilarious cutscenes, but then there were an evil cutscene if you didn't do anything, and I was scared of actually getting that back in the day, because that fucking ending is fucking twisted. Like a lot of like the Abe's Odyssey games, if you get the bad ending, you need to save a certain amount to get like the neutral ending, and then you can get a good ending. But then if you get the bad ending, or I believe in the first game there's only a bad ending and a good ending, the good ending you need to save everyone, I believe, but the bad ending is really fucking bad. Like, you become food. I think in the first game you become food when you die. In the second game you what happened in the second game, I forgot. But in the third game, then with Munch Odyssey, like, they basically allow Abe and the other thing to get captured, where Abe has already been put with his head on the wall, and then the other thing escaped basically because they were gonna, you know, take his caviar, and then they were basically gonna cut something out of one of his lungs or something like that, or his heart basically, and then they're basically operating on him without any kind of luck, you know, like, you know, the things that you get, like, before they operate you and stuff that, you know. So, yeah. You know, that's really twisted. But yeah, so, so yeah, constructs. Really, I haven't seen any other construct, really. Why did I think there were so many constructs in the game? I mean, wax elemental, that's definitely more of a construct rather than an elemental, because being wax is not an elemental. This is basically a wax golem. And a wax golem, that's a construct, not an elemental. That would be definitely have the construct tag if it existed in the game. But then it would be confusing for new players, like what things would still have elemental tag, what things would be a construct. This would be a construct, that water thing, the water looking elemental from Mongoro, would not be an elemental anymore. Ugh, my throat is getting bad now, so I should, yeah. Because I ran out of water and I ran away. Ugh. Which is why I'm doing the things with the throat now. I thought about taking another throat pill though. Okay, what's another construct? Harvest golems aren't construct though. I mean, they are golems. So basically it would be a mech and construct maybe for the ones. Instead of removing the old tag, maybe just add a new tag to it. Same thing with those that are elementals and more like constructs that have still let them have the elemental tag but also have the construct tag. Because there are definitely times when an elemental is a construct. This, which has a lot of tags here, elemental, mech, demon, warlock, dragon. I would instead say that this is mostly mech. But I would definitely say make it a construct instead. And then they can like remove all the other tags. And then, yeah, sure, this is nice because this can benefit you in elemental decks. This can benefit mech decks. This could benefit demon decks. This could benefit warlock decks. This can benefit dragon decks. This can benefit beast deck, pirate decks, and totem decks. Which is very, very interesting because there's a lot of buff cards that exist. So that would basically count as a construct. And so yeah, there are mechs definitely that does count as a construct. Tooty chest, that's definitely a construct because it's a mimic, and a mimic is, yeah, you know, like that's a construct. Tar creeper. Tar isn't an element. You would say that, oh, it's part of like earth elementals, which, you know, I guess would make sense, or like a type of water elemental, but not really. I mean, oil is not water, but you know, the thing is, tar creeper is definitely a construct rather than anything else, because it's not a natural elemental. I mean, tar kinda is natural, but you know what I mean, that would be a construct. Void Dripper, that's of course because it's one of those Void Lord kind of style things. Voodoo Doll would fall on a construct because basically you have used magic on it to make it do voodoo stuff. Walnut Sprites. Sprites are of course magical beings, but they don't serve anyone in particular, like sprites. I mean, they kind of serve the forest, but you could still count it as a construct, probably because it probably doesn't really have a mind on its own. So this would be construct, question mark, or otherwise like sprite, or like magical, or like fairy style, or whatever, because, you know, like there are several things, like sprites could be in that category, and like several other things. So we're gonna see any more constructs. Mogus aren't, I mean, Mogus don't look like, Mogus are humanoid, but Mogus are like more like, they aren't made of like flesh. I believe they are more stone like than anything, the Mogus. And the Mogus were created, right? And Mogus just feel like the Mogus would make sense if they would be constructs actually. Or certain Mogu things. Because there are like Mogus in like Mogushan vaults that aren't like real Mogu. They are more like statues, and those definitely would be constructs. Ugh. I have a question, why is it called Pilot the Reaper? You don't see the pilot in here. I'm guessing the thing, okay, is the flavor makes sense, right? Because it summons whoever the pilot was. But then certain things that it can summon makes no sense. That would be the pilot. Oh, I should have a sand binder in my elemental decks actually. So will we come across another construct? That's a mech. Yeah, that's a mech. That's not a construct. This of course was a construct. I've already said that. That's a mech definitely. Although, here's the thing, right? since it's unpowered, then that means that that mech shouldn't be able to move, because mechs need electricity, or they need whatever luck is powering them. And since it's unpowered, that means the only thing that makes it move around is magic. Basically, so it's magic that makes it move around. Because it's not just a stationary mech that you can hit, basically. Because then it shouldn't be, have been able to attack you, even if it gets buffed. So that means that that's a construct now, rather than a mech. Where it would basically be mech and construct. So yeah. Abomination. This doesn't even count as undead, so an abomination is basically like an undead construct. This one is mech and construct because it's an automaton, which is more like construct-like than the other mechs are. Like, not all mechs are construct, but some mechs are. Fen Creeper, that's not... Oh, look who it is! Isn't that... Where is she? Alright, she won't show up there, but still... Oh damn, now I need to go to where I was. I'd gone very, very far though. I'd gone to... No, I think we went too far. It's around here somewhere. This is the Warlock Hero. But she's on another giant, supposedly she's supposed to be on. Otherwise, Fang Creeper is exactly the same card as another card. I would definitely say the Fang Creeper would be a construct of whoever that is. This would not be a construct. Loose specimen, you could say that I made it a construct because it got part of several things. Yes, it's a beast, but you could call it a construct depending on if it has its own will or not. Rotten Apple Blum would definitely be like a construct because it's a magical tree and it comes to life. The yellow things. Do oozes and stuff that count as the constructs? Yeah, they do because they're actually magical. So that thing and the earlier slimes have counted as constructs. This thing is a mech, definitely. That's not a construct. So the Calamos is called a construct. Rather than metal. I mean, it is water on fire, so it's not a construct, actually. My bad. What else is construct material? This thing here is very, very interesting, because if you see, this is a mech, right? Yeah, it's mech, definitely. But it's a construct. See the blue stuff here? That's not like electricity or magnetic things that are holding it together. This is actually more like its soul. If that makes sense, that there's a soul in this, or like magic is basically the thing that's powering it. And I'm guessing when you would kill it in Bliss Souls or in Warcraft Souls, it would basically just fall apart. Poof, like animated armor. It's basically like an animated armor. An animated suit of armor is kind of what it is, or an animated mech. Because this is already dead, because it gets no power otherwise than just the magic. So, because you can see these things floating as well, so. This is a construct, a mech construct, basically, is what it is. And as I said, this is a construct. An elemental construct, you could say. Phenosphere Colossus, that's definitely a construct-style thing. Because, yeah, it's looking like a Raikou a bit, but it looks like, yes, it's humanoid, but it's also like a construct, because this is more like in terms of like a golem-style thing, so... You could argue that the Bone Drake is a construct, because... It's a dragon that they have resurrected again with magic, like the Lich King does. So this is basically like a dragon undead construct. Ettins are giants, they are not constructs, obviously. Missile also same thing with this. But this one you can actually see that it's electricity here. You can see this is electricity, obviously, that's holding it together. That's not the same thing. Because if you go back and look on this again, you can see that this is not electricity, this is more like a soul thing. Especially when it's animated like this, you can definitely see how it's... Yeah. mostly horrors. That's a construct, but like a nature construct. There are like many different versions of constructs. And that's a wind elemental. That's also like fire and water elemental. War golem, definitely a construct. And Morgan abomination. That's basically not the same thing as a regular undead abomination. So I mean that would be more of a construct style thing. A worm god. That's like an undead thing, but it's a rider of something. That feels like that would be an undead construct. The bone mass would be undead construct. Yes, it's like an undead horse, but it's... But you could basically say it's a construct because the horse is kind of... Yeah. Primordial drake, actually. I've said that those are constructs. Those aren't like regular drakes. Or maybe it is... Bulldozer, that also makes, of course. But yeah, so those basically all the constructs in standard. I'm actually gonna just finish it here just because I'm not gonna think about what I'm gonna have in it. I'm gonna have to think more when I can play it on my own. So I think we have played enough for this time. I'm probably gonna now go and take a shower, maybe. Do that first, but I'm probably gonna start the uploads first. Go and fill up a little bit of water, and then I'm probably gonna go and take the shower then. Anyway, start uploading while I'm doing that, and then maybe I will go and play more Hearthstone, or maybe I will log into WoW. Because I wanna check if the Halloween thing has started, because there are some things I wanna get during this Halloween, some of the toys and pets that you can get, because there are some pretty cool stuff. Like the costumes that you can get. I have the Van Cleef one, but I know there's an Arthas one. I kind of wish that they would make them into toys and stuff like that. That would make sense. Like, yes, you know, because, you know, like maybe once it's at one shot, you know. There we go. So anyway, that will do it for this time. I hope you all enjoy this and stuff, you know, and this won't go up immediately because I will focus on uploading all the other stuff first. And I know that I don't have very, very long left because it's the 17th now. Next week, and like the next week is basically, so not the next week but the week after that's gonna be the thing. And I mean, I know that it's gonna take a long time to upload the remaining clips I have because there is a shit ton of them. So basically I should probably be trying to schedule and then stick to uploading said clips each day, because I wanna have to try and calculate, because I calculated basically like if a video would take 20 minutes to upload and then the processing would take even long, because usually I let the processing finish before I do another upload. But then the main problem is, do I start several uploads at once? And like, that is the question, like, do I do that or not, you know, but yeah. But anyway, I hope you will all have enjoyed this, and on this clock and run, by the way. I don't know if I've shown this or not yet, but yeah, this is the clock and run. Because I really like, I haven't used this in a while though. And stuff like that, but yeah, but the rum is really good to mix with Coke. Especially with the Pepsi. With the Pepsi lime thing, because the lime thing, lime works really well with rum. What you might not know is pirates have all ordered something here in Sweden, or in Swedish you call it sjöbjugg, and in English you call it, I knew what it was but then I forgot, not scab, because scab is a thing on the skin. What do you call it? You not scallywag. I had it in my head. I was gonna say what it was in English first rather than saying what it was in Swedish first, and then I just forgot about it. Scurvy, yeah, like, oh, scurvy dog. But then it's like scurvy is kind of a thing for sjöbjugg, I think. I'm pretty certain it is, because that's when you don't get enough C vitamin, or there's all of a certain vitamin enough. And then the way the pirates avoided that was to actually, in the rum concoction or something that was similar to rum that they made, the grog or whatever you call it in like Swedish, the thing that they made was something, and it had like a lemon or lime in it, and those things prevented them from getting scurvy pretty much. So yes, Anyway, that will do it for this time. I hope you all will enjoy this whenever I upload this, and I don't know exactly when it's going to be, but I will be prioritizing uploading the 3 clips today of the funnel of the BlizzCon things. And they have shown the reward, what it is in StarCraft 2 and stuff that. It's just a portrait and then basically 3 things that you can unlock. The bad thing is they have also done a box that you can buy, which gives you a thing in StarCraft 2. And that just feels like, why have that? I can understand because those things go towards the esports scene, but I kind of wish that if you got the virtual ticket, you would get a bigger discount on that, and you can choose to buy a special version of the box if you only want to support Terran, Protoss, or Zerg, you know, and stuff that, that's something you could do, but otherwise that box is just so expensive, you know, and I've already spent more than enough, you know, because I've spent enough what that would be for like 2 months, so I spent literally all the stuff for October and November, and then in December I will probably decide what games to get for Christmas. I'll probably be getting dang games that I missed, like the Spyro Remaster. I will probably get the Mega Man 11 then at that point, and maybe the Graveyard Keeper game, and then probably be pre-order Resident Evil 2, the most expensive edition of that, unless they're gonna like black have that you can pre-order the remake from somewhere, probably. So anyway, I'll see you all next time.